يسعد مساكن. صار موعدنا ثابت عندكن كل نهار جمعة الساعة 8 المساء لنلتقى ونخبركن عن آخر الأخبار والأفكار والخطوات يلي فيها تساعدكن للعناية بنفسكن أكتر. وبما أنه ابتدت الصيفية، يعني ابتدى مع موسم الأعراس، وبلشت كل عروس بالاهتمام بكل تفاصيل عرسها. لهالسبب رح نحاول نساعد قد ما فينا من إصداء نصائح للعروس لحتى تكون ليلة عرسها ليلة ما بتنتسى. بأول فقراتنا، فقرة بيوتي، منقدم لك 6 أمور جمالية لازم تتفاداها العروس قبل عرسها. تحقيق إطلالة ساحرة بيوم عرسك قادرة على جذب الأنظار حواليك، هيدا الموضوع منه سهل. لتوصلي لهالهدف في 6 أمور جمالية لازم تتفاديها قبل عرسك. أول شيء لازم تتفادي قبل عرسك هو تلوين شعرك. بينصحك الخبير العالمي بالتجميل بول لابريك بعدم تغيير لون شعرك قبل أسبوع من عرسك، حتى لو كنتي عم بتقومي بهالشي هيدا مع أهم الخبراء، لأنك غير قادرة على معرفة كيف بده يكون اللون مع لون بشرتك. تاني شي لازم ما تقومي فيه قبل عرسك هو تغيير جذري بقصة شعرك. كما بينصحك الخبير لابريك بعدم قص الشعر أو القيام بغير ذلك من الأمور المتعلقة بتسريحة شعرك، يعني لازم تبتعدي عن أي أمر مماثل من هالنوع قبل موعد عرسك بثلاث أشهر. مشان هيك حافظي على قصة الشعر نفسها، لأنه أي تغيير ممكن ما يتماشى لا مع فستانك ولا مع الأكسسوارات يلي بدك تلبسيها بيوم العرس. ثالث شي لازم ما تعمليه هو تسمير الجسم أو التانينج. يمكن يكون التسمير مش بالطرق الطبيعية، يعني من خلال الغرف المجهزة أو التانينج باتس، بس في احتمالات كتيرة إنه ما يتلائم اللون مع اللون يلي بده يطلع عليك، إنه يمكن ما يعجبك اللون مثل ما بدك، أو يمكن يؤدي هالشي هيدا لمشاكل جلدية غير متوقعة. من هون الأفضل إنه تلجأي لخبير التجميل، هيك فيه يضع لك محلول بيعطي بشرتك اللون الأسمر يلي بيناسبك وبيناسب الفستان. رابع شي هو تغيير المكياج. بعض الأحيان بتحس العروس بالخوف قبل العرس، وهذا شي طبيعي. بتخاف يمكن تكون بالغت بالمكياج أو يمكن خففت. مشان هيك لازم تنعطى العروس فرصة تجربة أكثر من لوك. جربي أكثر من لوك لترتاحي باللوك يلي بتحسي إنه هيدا هو يلي بديه. بالنهاية عليك إنه توثقي بالخبير يلي عم تتعاملي معه، فهو أكيد رح ياخد بعين الاعتبار لون بشرتك وعمرك وشعرك، بالإضافة لطلتك بالكاميرا وموقع العرس. بيجمع الخبراء عادة أو خبراء التجميل على ضرورة شرب المي والنوم لساعات كافية للمحافظة على بشرة مشرقة، وهالشي عطول نحنا منكرره تقريباً بكل حلقاتنا وبفقرة هيلث أو بفقرة نيوتريشن، على ضرورة شرب المي وعلى ضرورة النوم لساعات كافية لحتى تضل بشرتك مشرقة وعم بتضوي. خامس شي ما لازم تعمليه هو التقشير أو البيلينج. بينصحك خبراء التجميل بتقشير البشرة قبل الزفاف بأربع أسابيع على الأقل، لأنه بعض الأحيان بيتسبب بترك جلد ميت على البشرة، هالشي يلي بينعكس سلباً على المكياج وبيؤدي لبعض الأحيان لحكة قوية وتهيج بالبشرة. سادس شي وآخر شي هو ما لازم تستعملي كريمات جديدة لبشرتك. ما تغيري مستحضرات العناية ببشرتك قبل أسبوعين أو ثلاثة من عرسك، لأنه بعض المستحضرات يمكن تسبب لك حساسية أو جفاف أو يمكن تزييت أو غير هيك من بعض الأثار يلي أنت منك بحاجة لإلها بوقت ونهار عرسك. مع هالنصايح هيدي بتمنى أنه تكوني جاهزة 100% بنهار عرسك وتكوني أجمل عروس، ونتمنى لك الهنا والسعادة والتوفيق. تاني فقرة بحلقتنا لليلة فقرة هيلث، مثل ما صرتوا تعرفوا. بفقرة هيلث بدنا نحكي عن التعب الجسدي والإرهاق المستمر، أسبابه وكيفية علاجه. أول سبب للإرهاق والتعب الجسدي هو قلة النوم. سألتي حالك نهار شنهار إنه هل عم نام كفاية؟ إذا كانت الحاجة للنوم تختلف باختلاف العمر والأشخاص، فإن المدة المثالية للنوم خلال الليل كمان بتعتمد على كل حالة على حدة، إذ تكفي ليلة نوم مؤلفة من 6 ساعات للأشخاص قليلي النوم، بحين الأشخاص يلي بحبوا النوم تكفيهم من 9 ل 10 ساعات نوم. تاني سبب بسبب التعب الجسدي والإرهاق يمكن هو توقف التنفس أثناء النوم. بتصيب حالة توقف النفس أثناء النوم بعض الأشخاص، وغالباً بعد سن 50 خلال الليل. يؤدي توقف التنفس إلى عدة حالات استيقاظ بتغير نوعية النوم. والأسباب الأكثر شيوعاً لتوقف التنفس أثناء النوم هي زيادة الوزن. فما تترددي إذا حسيتي إنه عم بتصيبك هالحالة هيدي بطلب نصيحة الدكتور وإرشاداته بهالموضوع هيدا. ثالث سبب هو النظام الغذائي الغير متوازن. النظام الغذائي الغير متوازن بيؤدي لنقص بعض العناصر الغذائية بالجسم، وبما أنه الغذاء هو وقود الجسم فإنه نقص الفيتامينات والكربوهيدرات والبروتينات والمعادن بيؤدي للإحساس بالتعب. عليك إذن تتناولي وجبة إفطار غنية لبدء اليوم بشكل جيد، وتحاول الحصول على تغذية متنوعة ومتوازنة. رابع سبب ممكن يكون نقص الحديد. ممكن يؤدي نقص الحديد بالجسم لفقر الدم، أي انخفاض عدد الخلايا الحمراء بالدم، فبقل مستوى الأكسجين بالدم، وبيكون التعب أحد العلامات التحذيرية لنقص الحديد. ركزي على تناول الأطعمة الغنية بالحديد مثل اللحوم والأسماك والبقول مثل الفاصوليا والعدس. خامس سبب وهو سبب كتير مهم ولازم ننتبه له، وهو الاكتئاب. بيعاني عدد كبير من الأشخاص حول العالم من الاكتئاب، وهالمرض هو أحد الأمراض النفسية الأكثر شيوعاً، وبيؤدي عموماً لنقص الطاقة وبالتالي للتعب المزمن. خذ الاكتئاب على محمل الجد لأنه مرض حقيقي، وكتير في حلول لإله طبية لعلاجه. فما تترددي أبداً إذا حسيتي أنه أنت بحالة اكتئاب أنك تتوجهي كمان للدكتور لأخذ النصيحة والاستشارة. سادس السبب هو اضطراب الغدة الدرقية أو الثايرويد جلاند. الغدة الدرقية هي غدة بتنتج هرمونات ضرورية لعمل الجسم. من أعراض نقص الغدة الدرقية التعب العام بالجسم، ويمكن علاج هالحالة يكون بسهولة بالأدوية أو بجراحة بسيطة. سابع سبب هو الإفراط بالكافيين. نحن منحس أو منفكر أنه إذا شربنا كتير كافيين منضلنا صاحيين وبيعطينا طاقة، هيدا بالعكس. جرعات معتدلة بتحسن القهوة التركيز واليقظة جداً، بس الإفراط بالكافيين بيؤدي لنتيجة عكسية تماماً وبيسبب التعب. قللي لكينا من استهلاكك للكافيين عن طريق تقليل تناول القهوة، الشاي والمشروبات الغازية. ثامن سبب هو السكري يلي بيعاني منه الملايين حول العالم، وخصوصاً بدولنا العربية. التعب المفرط قد يكون أحد أعراض هالمرض المزمن، وبعض الحالات بيكفي اتباع بعض التغييرات بنمط الحياة للشخص المصاب بالسكري للعلاج، أو تناول الأدوية اللازمة تحت إشراف طبي. تاسع سبب هو ضعف القلب. إذا صارت النشاطات اليومية متعبة وبيصعب القيام فيها بشكل مفاجئ، يمكن يكون السبب ضعف بالقلب. فالقلب الذي لا يعمل بطريقة صحيحة بيؤدي للتعب العام، وقد يكون أحد علامات ذلك التنفس السريع. فما تترددي إذا شعرتي بهالعلامات أو بهالأعراض إنه تتحدثي مع طبيبك لأخذ الإرشادات أكيد. عاشر سبب وآخر سبب وهو عدم ممارسة الرياضة بشكل كافي. إذا كانت فكرة ممارسة الرياضة بتعبك ففكري مرة تانية، لأنه الكسل بيؤدي للتعب كمان، وممارسة الرياضة بشكل منتظم بتساعد على مكافحة التعب. فمشان هيك تركي هالكنباية وطفي التي في، بس مش هلأ، بعد ما يخلص البروغرام، وروحي تمشي بنزهة طويلة سيراً على الأقدام. هذا إذا كان الطقس حلو. أنتوا بتعرفوا نحن بميشيغان، سو إذا كان الطقس حلو تهري لبرا ومشي وخدي نفس عميق، رح تحسي بالنشاط فوراً بس بشكل منتظم. أو إذا ما كان الطقس منيح فيك تروحي على أقرب جيم وتمارسي الرياضة يلي بتحبيها أو بتحبي تمارسيها. بنهاية فقرة هيلث بتمنى لكم الصحة الكاملة إن شاء الله وما تنصابوا بأي أمراض. وصلنا لفقرة انترفيو. انترفيو لهالأسبوع مع أميندا مظلوم، صاحبة محل My Wedding My Dress على 7237 Chase Road. خلينا نروح سوا للمقابلة، لأنه الأسئلة اللي سألتها لأميندا هي أسئلة بتكون براس أي عروس عم بتحضر حالها لعرسة، بدها تعمل شوبينج لفستان عرسة. سو خلينا نروح للمقابلة لنشوف شو جاوبتنا أميندا. ونسيت خبركم إنه عملت لنا like a mini fashion show، فرجتنا كل جديد صيف 2015. تابعونا. يسعد مساكن. شايفين اليوم كتير فستان سهرة ومغيرة اللوك، بس الانترفيو بتحتاج هيك شيء. الانترفيو لليوم كتير مميزة لأنه عم نستضيف معنا أميندا مظلوم. أميندا مظلوم أخصائية بفساتين الأعراس، وفينا نقول عنها أنها personal consultant، يعني أي استشارة بتختص بفساتين العرس، فساتين سهرة، فيها تقلكن إذا بيناسبكن هالفستان أو ما بيناسبكن. بما أنه نحن عبواب الصيفية والصيفية موسم أعراس، فحبيت بلش حلقتنا أو حبيت بلش موسمنا باستضافتها لأميندا لنحكي أكثر عن فساتين الأعراس، شو الفساتين اللي بتناسب أي أجسام، لأي نوع بشرة ولأي ألوان بشرة. ما حأحكي كتير، رح خلي الحكي والأجوبة لأميندا، بس أميندا بدها تحكينا بالإنجليش، سو رح حاول قد ما فيني كمان أني ترجم وننتقل دغري لأميندا. هاي أميندا.
هاي، how are you؟
Good. How are you؟
I'm doing great, thank you.
How is work?
Very busy. Busy, wedding season, right? Yes.
Yep.
Weddings and proms and every formal.
Busy, busy. Yes. So I'm going to change the style of the interview this time. I'm going to assume that I'm a bride.
Okay.
And at your store. And I'm going to ask you the most frequent questions that a bride may ask you.
Absolutely.
So we can answer all the questions that the brides are questioning themselves. The first question would be, how far in advance should the bride start shopping for the dress, the wedding dress?
Yes, this is a great question. And not many people know that it does take time to actually make the dress. In my case, I do custom made. Mm-hmm. So you come in, you choose your style. We go through many different processes. It only takes me 6 weeks on a busy month, you know, when it's really busy with weddings. Sometimes less than four, but you have to have your wedding dress in hand at least 3 months in advance. Mm-hmm. That way, brides get nervous, they lose weight, they gain weight, we have time for alterations. Mm-hmm. You may see something that wasn't out when you purchased your dress that you want to add to your dress. Okay. And there's so many different things that you can do in that case. If you don't have it in advance, you just get what you get off the rack, and it's not really what you want.
Mm-hmm. اوكي، سو سألت لأميندا انه قديه قبل بوقت لازم نطلب او نعمل اوردر على فستان العرس، او نبلش نعمل شوبينج نشوف يعني اي فستان بيناسبنا واي فستان بنحبه. عم بتقلي انه يعني مفروض قبل بثلاث اشهر نبلش نفتش على الفساتين، لانه خلال هالفتره يعني ممكن العروس تحت ضغط الستريس والتوتر للعرس والتحضير للعرس ممكن تضعف، ممكن يزيد وزنها. سو تفسح لها مجال انه تعمل كل التغييرات، تضييق، توسيع، شيء ما زبط تزبطه. سو خلال هالثلاث اشهر يعني بيصير عندها وقت لاي تزبيط او اي تصليح بالفستان. فثلاث اشهر كثير منيح تنبلش نفتش على فستان عرسنا. Okay, our next question would be how long will the bride stay at your store for consultation?
Okay, this is a great question too. Initial consultation, I ask the bride to set aside 2 to 4 hours. And this is because you want to try on every single dress, every style. Do you want poofy? Do you want mermaid? There's so many different styles and different dresses. It's not really about the look, the beading. It's about the style, the body shape, the silhouette that's going to be perfect on your body. In order to do that, you have to try on everything. So you're going to take a lot of time looking through the dresses, picking the ones that you want to actually try on. Then you have to try them on, and most brides won't be out of that dress in 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. They want to look, they want to see every angle. They want to turn and selfies and take pictures, mm-hmm. and, you know, really see the details in the dress. So if you pick 5-6 dresses, 20 minutes a piece, just trying on dresses, you've got an hour and a half. Mm-hmm. Then we need to sit down and say, okay, your wedding date is this date. We want to make sure that we order by this date. We want to make sure that we have the perfect dress for you. So are you sure you like this style back? We actually pick the different pieces of the dress and we put it into a custom-made, unique, original dress no other bride has worn. Mm-hmm.
So, بسؤالنا لأماندا على الوقت اللي بيستغرقوا الكونسلتيشن عندها بالمحل، قالت من 2 لـ 4 ساعات. السبب هو انه أماندا بتحب العروس تجرب everything عندها بالستور، يعني كل الستايلز، كل الموديلات بتحب تجربهم، بتحب تشوف انه هي مرتاحة بهالستايل المعين او بهالستايل اللي نقته، بتحب تشوف كل تفصيل يعني، وكله هيدا بياخد وقت. مشان هيك بتفضل انه يعني تاخد العروس وقتها لحتى بالاخير تنقي فستان هي مقتنعه فيه وحابته. Talking about trying different styles, do you feel some customers come having in mind specific style and they won't try any other styles and maybe the other style will fit them more?
Yes, we have this a lot. So traditional is ball gown. Mm-hmm. Everybody wants to wear a ball gown on their wedding day. Not everybody's body shape, body type is good for a ball gown. If you're shorter, it makes you look very short when you put a ball gown on, or very wide. Or the other style is mermaid. Everybody wants to wear a mermaid, mm-hmm. but not everybody has the body type for that. You really have to be proportionate. You have to have hips, honestly. You know, you can have the top of your body, it doesn't matter, but if you don't have hips, this makes the mermaid dress. So if you're 30, 30, 30, mm-hmm. it's a straight line. It gives no beauty to the dress. Mm-hmm. So absolutely, that's why I encourage everyone, try on every single style, even if you know you don't like it, mm-hmm. because something will it catch you. I've done it so many times with, you know, everybody's like, oh no, I don't like this because I'm 6 feet tall. Mm-hmm. But it's beautiful. It's beautiful when you actually see it on. It's beautiful. It makes you feel like a princess when you put something else on. It's not just traditional. So yeah, everybody has this in their mind. And I always try to convince them, try every style on. You have 5 different styles of dress. You really need to try them all.
Yeah, sometimes like it happens to me too. Yes. Like I look at something, I look at a dress, I see, I won't try it. I don't like it. But once I try it, it really looks yeah. really, really amazing. Yeah. So it's really important to try everything. حديثنا كان مع أماندا. سؤالنا الثاني انه في عرايس بيجوا حاطين ببالهم ستايل معين وما بدهم يجربوا غيره. بس نصيحتها لأماندا هي انه العروس تجرب everything لأنه يمكن اللي شايفته على التعليقة أو اللي شايفته على الفيترين ومش عاجبها إذا جربته يطلع أنسب بكتير من اللي هي حطته ببالها. فيا عرايس جربوا كل أنواع الفساتين والستايلات. أماندا, how many fitting sessions or the bride need?
So in my business structure is a little bit different because I do custom made. So when a bride comes in, I'll actually do her measurements and make her dress according to those measurements. The only style we don't do according to her measurements, we'll add a little, is a mermaid, because it does need to fit your curves. So ideally, the dress fits when it comes in. It's always, you're going to have to nip and tuck something because you're not there when my tailors are actually putting that dress together. So it's kind of like a standard. But if you're, if you come in and I measure you and you're 36, 24, 36, your dress will ideally come in that size. If it's a standard size, because you do have the option just to go with, oh, I need a size 8, then usually it's two fittings after that. And we'll do alterations for that.
Okay, so the fitting أو البروفا مثل ما بسموها البعض هي بس بتاخذ القياسات أميندا لكل الستايلات من عدا الميرميد لأنه في عنده قياسات معينة. الفستان يعني بيجي فت لما بيوصل يعني لما بيخلص بتعمل له البروفا للعروس، وإذا في شيء يعني صغير يتزبط بيتزبط بوقتها يعني، بس other than that يعني بدها مرتين، يعني مرة للقياس لتاخذ القياسات ومرة لتقيس الفستان ويتزبط إذا كان في شيء بده تزبيط. What about the built-in the inside garments, the built-in bras and corsets? What do you tell us about that?
All wedding dresses come with a built-in bra. Some need more support than other, and we can put the full back corset inside the dress, but it depends on the style. Usually that's a princess that has a high cut. A lot of the dresses now are simply the bra up here and the strap, which has to be adjusted to your body size once it gets here. But there's a lot of other garments that you can put on in addition to what's already built in the dress. If your dress has boning, you normally don't need that, which is the long plastic piece that kind of, I think this dress, you might see has some. It keeps the dress straight and keeps it nice on your body. You don't normally have to have a corset. If it's something like this particular dress or a lot of ball gowns, they don't have boning because it's all about just the poofiness. Then sometimes you'd want to have a corset. You want to put it on to pull in areas that you might not want to show.
Yep. So since you are a personal consultant, Amanda, of course you suggest some suggestion to the brides or advice, if we can say. You take into consideration the skin tone, the body type. You may take into consideration too the place where the wedding is happening, whether it's outside or inside. So tell us more about this stuff. Well, for the skin tone, for example, first. And
I think the one good thing to understand is that wedding dresses are not traditional white anymore. They're white, they're ivory, they're pink. They're champagne. And when we do the fashions, you'll see a couple of mine that are the newest style, which is the two-tone dresses, which I absolutely love. I was not fond of them previously, but I actually love them. They're gorgeous. But you have to really take, you know, if you're as white as I am, I don't want to wear a white dress. I'll blend away. No matter how much jewelry you put on me, I'm really white. So if you're more a darker skin tone or tanner skin tone, champagnes probably are not going to be good on you. Hair color, it's a big deal. Because if you're a redhead, you probably don't want to go with a champagne dress. So now we see wedding dresses, there's so many different colors. There's white with color in it. This is a big thing this year. White or ivory dresses with colored beading. This is really big. Maybe they want to incorporate their wedding colors in their dress. This is something that we want to kind of sit down and see what your wedding colors are. Does it work? Because it doesn't work with every color. And, you know, just creative ideas. So you can have an original, unique dress that's up to date, today's fashions, today's styles, but completely different than everybody else.
And what about the location of the wedding?
Location. So the biggest thing, everybody wants a long, huge train. This is everybody. If you're outside and you're getting married outside, it's probably not ideal. Number one, your wedding dress, it's going to cost a lot of money.
Yeah.
So that long train's just going to drag through the probably wet grass that you're walking through. And it's heavy. It's heavy. Mm-hmm. This is a big thing because you have to carry that dress. You're not going to take that dress off. Mm-hmm. Unless you change into a reception dress. Some people do, but not when you spend that kind of money on a dress. Mm-hmm. You want to wear it the whole night and probably sleep in it too. So you have to think about, okay, is this something that I'm going to do? What am I going to wear under it as far as a petticoat? You want poofy, you have to have a skirt that goes under it that brings the poofy out. Mm-hmm. Poofy is not just the dress, it's what's under it. Mm-hmm. Are you going to be able to carry that outside? If you're inside, is it going to be a cool day outside or is it going to be hot? Do you want sleeves? Do you want an open back? So many things to really consider. And also with color, because if you're in a hall and the hall's colors are gold and red and you decide, oh, my colors for my wedding are gold and red, it's probably going to look odd. Too much. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot that really has to go into place. What's the lighting like in wherever you're getting married, in the hall or in the, outside? Is it going to be a twilight wedding where it's nighttime? You're going to do candles. So you want something soft. You want your wedding, even bridesmaids, all of that. Mm-hmm. You want them to be soft and be able to blend into the atmosphere. So I really try to sit down and understand, which is why initial consultations take 2 to 4 hours.
Time. Okay.
Yes, because you want to understand every aspect. What's the mother wearing? What color is the mother wearing? So much.
So you ask these questions to the bride.
Absolutely.
You try to know every single detail so you can give her the perfect dress, right?
The perfect dress, but then you have to, she has to get her bridesmaids' dresses. They have to go with everything too. Mm. There's so much that goes into it. It's not just a wedding dress. It's a wedding party. And then it's the mother. And then it's their friend. And then it's the guest. And then the mother of the groom. So there's like a whole...
The whole two families.
Exactly, exactly. And then each of them have, 500 guests each?
No.
So now we're really talking a lot of work. Mm-hmm. But this is the fun part of what I do. Mm-hmm. This is like creating something unique and different every single time, which is, it's unbelievable. And this is the most important day of somebody's life. Really.
Yep, it is.
It is. When you get into that wedding dress.
Once in a lifetime.
You'll never do it again. Mm-hmm. So to be a part of that, it's exciting. Mm-hmm. When you see somebody walks in, it happens. Somebody can come in and say, oh, I love that dress. I want it. But it's very rare.
It doesn't work that way.
It's very rare. I've had one person do it and still in the end, we changed a lot.
Okay.
So when you create that original, unique dress for that person and they understand, wow, nobody's going to wear this. Just me, ever in a lifetime, unless you give it to your daughter or mm-hmm. whatever you do, it's exciting for them because they don't have to spend a fortune to get this beauty. That's the biggest thing.
That's why you have the slogan, gorgeous is not expensive.
Doesn't have to be expensive. Exactly.
This is the slogan for the store, right?
Exactly.
Yep.
Exactly.
And yeah, exactly. It doesn't have to be expensive to be gorgeous.
It doesn't.
Yep.
And you can have everything you want in a dress. You don't have to settle for off-the-shelf dress, mm-hmm. and which is what a lot of people do. They'll go to a chain boutique and, oh, it's Vera Wang. I'll take that. Mm-hmm. Well, it doesn't have to be just that.
Yep.
And how many people wore that?
Yeah. So speaking about expensive and money and prices, would you mind tell us a hint about the prices, like the starting prices you have at the store for a wedding dress?
Wedding dresses as low as $500. Mm-hmm. This is ordinary plain dress. But average dress ranges between $700 and $900. Mm-hmm. And that's depending on the beading. I think the most expensive dress that I have is $2,000.
Mm-hmm. And so is it only the beading or the fabric too?
So fabric is going to depend on the style of dress. It's going to depend on what you feel comfortable with. Fabric is a very detailed section of the dress.
Do you decide the fabric or the bride decide?
It depends the look that she wants. If she wants poofy, I can tell you there's two types of dresses, two types of fabric. You have organza, you have tulle.
Okay.
I'm not a fan of tulle. But it's the lighter, nicer fabric to wear. Mm. It gives you that poof. You can put many, many layers, but it's not. It doesn't keep its straightness. Mm. When you use organza, you get the same look, but you never have to steam it.
Okay.
So there's tricks and there's things that you really have to know about, you know, a dress. If you want something that's really fitted, but not a mermaid, but like a sheath dress, the best material is chiffon because it falls and it flows. It's a 2-second steam job. Those are really important things because on your wedding day, you're worried about the caterer didn't make it, the cake's not right. You don't want to worry about your dress not, you know, steaming, ironing. Sure. I didn't get my hair done right. You know, there's too much to worry about. So, I mean, it really depends on the style of the dress. Lace is a really big deal. But lace applique is an even bigger deal because it doesn't look like a curtain.
Lace is not,
I'm not a fan of lace. There's some that is beautiful. But when you use applique lace on tulle, it gives it that weight. It weighs it down. And you get the beauty of lace. And you can create so many styles with this.
With that.
That one, the same lace can create 100 different styles. It's where you place it, how you place it, where you're wearing it.
And does the price include the alteration too?
The prices do not include alterations. Alterations usually range depending on what they are. Like I told you, they're minimal for me. Unless you want me to put rhinestones on from top to bottom on your dress. That's a little expensive. But alterations, usually it's just a nip and a tuck. They can range anywhere from $40 to $100. That's all up to my seamstress. She's amazing. And she's very fast. I love her beading. If I give her this dress you're wearing and say I want to add sleeves and I want the beading on it to be just like that, she will make it exact. She's amazing with her craft.
Good.
So, very affordable. You know, it's not like your traditional store where you pay $500 for alterations and minimum. I don't do that. If you don't need alterations, save that money. I invite another guest.
Or something. And do you offer preservation services after the wedding for the dress, I mean?
Yes. So that's a personal choice to do it.
Okay.
And I'll tell you why. I've seen dresses that I also take donations for wedding dresses to donate to a group that makes baby burial gowns for babies that don't make it from the hospital. And most of those dresses were preserved. However, when you open them, they're stained. They're a mess.
Okay.
So what they did is they put it nice and pretty in a box and sprayed it with something.
Okay.
Cost you $200 to do, and they thought you'd never open the box. So there's things that you can do. There's actually this great kit, very inexpensive for a wedding dress. It comes with everything you need. You can do it at home. I'm all about saving money. That's the basis of my business. I don't think that you need to spend $1,000 on an evening dress to go to New Year's. You know, I'm all about saving money and giving my brides that help and in the avenues to save money. This is one way I do. There's a preservation kit. You do it at home. And it's $150 and it comes with everything you need. So I'll give them the information for that. But my personally, I don't feel that
you need to do it, you know? Okay. Yeah.
And you're probably going to sell your wedding dress anyway because your daughter's really not going to wear it.
Time changed, you know? Yeah.
Exactly.
One more question before I ask you our last question and we move to the fashion show we have. Do you suggest any accessories to go with the dress? Do you have anything? What kind of accessories you have to
go with the dress? So we have several different options. Headpieces and things of that nature are all custom made. I provide headpieces that are handcrafted by Breezy Way Headpieces. And she will literally look at your dress and create the perfect headpiece, whether it's rhinestones or an applique headpiece that matches your lace dress, anything like that. They're amazing and they're unique as well. This is what I like about everything that I do. It's unique. For accessories, I have hundreds. You'll see some on the models today. Hundreds of different styles of jewelry. It depends on the dress, obviously. If you're wearing a strapless dress, do you have straps? This is all going to play into what I would recommend for jewelry. There's, do your earrings need to be big? Do you need a necklace? Because if you have a high neck dress for your wedding, where you're going to put it. You know, your beading's probably at the top. And I have a couple of examples of those as well that we're going to see today. But it's, I will provide you everything you need, even if I have to go find it. We're going to provide
Like you provide everything from A to Z.
This
she doesn't
is my
have
goal.
To worry about anything.
We have, in this shopping center, it's a very unique shopping center. We have bridal everything in the store. Shoes. I don't sell shoes. Let me correct myself. But you bring your shoes in and I'll decorate them to match the dress that you need them for. We'll put, if it's a lace wedding dress, we'll put lace appliques that match your dress on your shoes. Or if you want rhinestones on your shoes, we'll create that shoe that goes perfect with that dress. Down the road or right next door is the bridal salon who does hair and makeup. Next to them is a laser. So the vision I had when I opened here last August, prior to that was in my home. And the vision I had is, wow, we have hair and makeup for bridal. We have Biblos across the street. Everybody knows Biblos. And I do everything wedding. So how perfect is that? You can park in this parking lot, get out, and just make your rounds.
You just cross the street.
And go home. This is the goal. So, you know, we have big plans, but, you know, right now this is perfect for us. We like it. And we do everything from flower girls to, I just don't do boy stuff.
Oh, okay.
Boy stuff isn't
cute. I was going to ask you about the flower girls.
Flower
and,
girls, yes.
The gowns you already talked about.
Yes.
Well, my last question will be, what's the trend for the summer?
This is the fun stuff.
Yeah.
So I've put together a few examples of the best trends for fashion this year. Two-piece dresses. This has been, for the last 2 months, top on everybody's list. Just a little bit of skin showing, but it's just enough to be different for bridal parties or engagement.
Even wedding dresses?
There are a lot of two-piece wedding dresses. I have a couple coming in, and usually I'll show my new stuff at the bridal shows that I do. I'm afraid to show them because I don't know that a bride will really wear it, but it's a nice concept. It's nice to say, hey, that's cute. So just for show, you know, I have it coming in. I'm not sure anybody will have that ability to wear a two-piece wedding dress on their wedding day, but, you know, they're beautiful.
You never know.
Yeah, maybe, you never know.
Maybe a bride wants to be very unique and
it is
different, you know,
definitely.
To try this experience.
But,
away from traditional, you know, dresses and...
It's a nice thought, but, you know, in the end, we really... It's going to take a lot. Because you really want that beauty on your wedding day, and you don't know how people will handle that. So I think once they come out in the evening dresses a lot more, you'll see brides going,
I They're
can
getting
do that.
Used to it more and more.
Yeah, and, you know, I can really see them on a beach wedding.
Yeah, okay.
It's the place. In a wedding hall or a church, I don't know.
We'll see. It's a little bit hard.
It's a little, you know, it's a, you know.
Okay. A question just popped out of in my mind now. Being here in Michigan, in Dearborn in specific, you know, you have many cultures, many customers from different backgrounds.
Absolutely.
So you have different tastes. So in dresses and in even wedding dresses or night dresses. What's the most demanding thing they demand here in this area, you know?
That no one else has worn that color or that style to a wedding.
Okay. They want to be unique.
Very unique. This is actually the most fun that I've had putting together bridal party dresses, the bridesmaids. When it's a separate wedding, they're not mixed weddings. The girls, obviously, they're going to go for it. And I've had some amazing dresses for bridal parties.
Okay.
Amazing.
It's a challenge too, right?
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun because nobody else has done it. You know, and there you can, when you can step out in this culture, it's not a bridesmaid's dress that they're looking for. It's something wow. And this is the fun because you're not just doing the one shoulder with a little bow here and it reaches the floor. You're doing something that's a wow dress. People are going to see it and they're going to want a wow dress. And this is what makes this area perfect. And of course, I have my sister-in-law who helps me a lot bring in different styles.
We should appreciate her help and everything.
Absolutely.
She's here with us anyway, and she's gonna show us a very nice dress. لكن بعد ما خلصنا كل أسئلتنا تقريباً لأماندا وجاوبتنا عليهم بتمنى تكونوا أخذتوا فكرة ولو مختصرة عن كيف بدكم تفتشوا على فساتين الأعراس. هلأ خلينا نشوف هالفاشن شو سمول فاشن شو لحتى نشوف عينات من الفساتين إن فساتين أعراس أو فساتين سهرة موجودين عند أماندا. تابعونا وخليكم معنا تشوفوا الفاشن شو.
يلا
Okay, then Amanda, we're gonna start with our first model now, and you're gonna talk about her dress, right?
Absolutely. Okay. Well, first model is Brittany. Mm-hmm. So a couple of things I want to mention is their hair was done for all the models by Coiffeur d'Elegance. So this is what I was speaking about earlier, where you can get your hair, makeup, everything done in the same place when you come here. Now, Brittany is wearing a lace high neck mermaid dress. This is one of the new styles. This is a shredded bottom, so it has that mermaid look, but it's kind of like a waterfall. It's a very nice dress because it's unique. This has a very low cut back and very simple beading, but it's beautiful. Mm-hmm. Dresses like this we would not wear a necklace with. However, we're gonna put hair pieces, we're gonna do jewelry, maybe bracelets and rings. This is gonna make the elegance of this dress stand out even more. So this is one of the newest styles for the year.
Do you suggest any veil with that dress?
With this dress, I do not. Okay. Because the bottom is where the vision is of this dress.
Okay.
If you put a veil, normally you're toning down something. Mm-hmm. So for this dress, no.
Okay, for our next model?
Our next model is Kendra. She is giving a beautiful display of one of our evening dresses. Again, her hair was done by Coiffeur d'Elegance here in Dearborn. This style is amazing because it's a sheath. It's not fitted, but it kind of flows on the curves of your body. It's a strapless, and if you notice, the detailing on this is all at the top. Mm-hmm. This is something you're gonna see a lot this year. All the rhinestones, everything is at the top, and then the bottom, it's simple and plain. This way, you can do a necklace, you can do earrings, you can really bring your hair out, or you don't have to at all. Mm-hmm. This is a beautiful, beautiful style, and your beading goes front to back. It's all the way around. Very affordable choice for any kind of occasion where you want to do a black tie event. Next model, this is going to be Trisha. I am in love with her hair. I've worked with her a lot and never seen her hair like this, and it's gorgeous. So Trisha is wearing one of our most popular designs for this year. This is one of the only dresses that I will only do in this color. In any of my other dresses, I'll change the color. But this dress, the beauty is in the gold and the silver, the way it's put together, and it sits upon the champagne chiffon. It's a flowy dress. The back is elegant. The back is beautiful. You don't need a stitch of jewelry around your neck.
Yep,
your earrings
absolutely
look amazing, blinging just like the top of this dress. And then again, like I was mentioning with Kendra's dress, the top is very, very blinged out. The bottom is very simple. Mm-hmm. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous dress. We do a lot for engagements. We do this a lot for bridesmaids. Mm. So it's a real trendy dress for this year. Mm-hmm. So now we have my sister-in-law, who we need to give a big round of applause for all her help. Yay!
Thank you.
So she is showing us a hijab style dress. So what I need everybody to know is, if it doesn't have sleeves, we'll put it. It's seamless. It does not look like it was added. The beading is added to match the top of the dress for the sleeves. We can add a lining, and for this particular dress, she actually wore just an undershirt. You can't really tell. She matched her hijab with the colors of the
beading.
And it's amazing. It's beautiful. It's a very modest dress, and it looks phenomenal on her. So it goes for anybody. This is for anyone.
And even if you took the sleeves off, it'd be amazing.
Mm-hmm. Our next dress.
Okay, next we have Brittany. Now, Brittany is wearing one of the most newer, one of the newer lace fashions. And it's not exactly a mermaid, it's a fit and flare. The long train, the buttons that go all the way down the back, they're so elegant. The scalloped edge on the train, the good thing about this dress, it's so easy to maintain. There's no beading to pop off except mm-hmm. the top. You don't have to worry about snagging your soon-to-be husband's trousers when you get out of the drawer mm-hmm. and beading falling off. This is such an elegantly beautiful dress. Again, all these fashions can come in any color. This one has such little beading at the top that to do it with a necklace like this is, or to not wear a necklace like this mm-hmm. is a sin. Yeah. You have to wear a necklace. You have to wear bling.
Okay.
This is, again, my sister-in-law, Kaula. She's wearing my phenomenal. I love this dress.
Beautiful.
The detail, the beauty. This is another example of a dress that comes with or without sleeves. However, we did this one with sleeves. We replicated the applique, it's gold applique with rhinestones, mm-hmm. onto the sleeve. So again, it looks seamless. It doesn't look like it was added. It looks like it was a part of this dress from the beginning. And of course, she makes it look even more beautiful. Kendra is wearing one of our hottest bridesmaids dresses this year. I have done this in so many colors and so wow. many different styles. This dress in silver, though, is phenomenal. It, mm-hmm. Nothing can beat this color. It is so beautiful. If you have a group of bridesmaids, the applique that sits in the center of the back, the illusion back, it just makes the dress amazing. Mm-hmm. It's silver and, you know, just another soft color with this, and just to kind of do something different, mix your bridesmaids' dresses, two different colors, something like that. Makes this even look more beautiful and elegant. Wow. The number one wow. fashion for 2015 is our two-piece dresses. This particular one, I just got in, I just did it. This is our two-piece mermaid dress. This is probably one of my favorite, most exciting dresses I've ever done. This is a few layers of tulle. There's a little sheet of satin under there. And then it is topped off with the most delicate lace. Lace is beautiful in a lot of dresses, but this one is just, it's wow. I mean, you
can't. It is
you
wow.
can't.
With the color?
The color,
I love the
yes.
color.
I don't think that I would do this dress in anything, any other colors. I would do it probably in a red and gold, mm-hmm. but it would have to be a bright neon color. Mm-hmm. I think it makes this dress. And that's my opinion, though. I'll do whatever anybody
what
wants.
About a blue?
If it were electric, yeah. if it was a bright, uh-huh. you know, not a dull blue, not a light blue, but an electric color, mm-hmm. I would totally do it. This one, I love these dresses. They zip up in the back. They're so easy to put on. They're so easy to take off. They're comfy. You know, you definitely stand out, whether it be your bridal shower, mm-hmm. your engagement party.
Exactly. That's what I was going to yeah. ask you. Is it good for engagement?
It's more bridal showers henna parties. We do a lot for henna parties.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
you know what? I can totally point this out to you now. Do you see how she has a figure? She's got butt. Mm. The hips fill this dress out. The fact that it's flared out at the bottom, and it's flared out with a skirt, mm-hmm. This makes this dress beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's the hips. So a lot of women, they say, oh, I can't wear that. It's a mermaid. I have big hips. That's beautiful in a dress.
That's the purpose of the
yes,
mermaid.
Yes. I would rather see a curvy woman in a mermaid dress any day of the week than a size zero, honestly, with yeah. no curves.
The bride with hijab, right?
Yes. This
Let's
is...
Let's see this.
One of my favorite.
Beautiful.
This is one of the newest styles. So this is actually a champagne lining mm-hmm. with ivory applique on top. This is the newest trend in wedding dresses. Mm-hmm. Now she's also doing a lace applique, full sleeve, illusion back. Again with this one, she put a shirt under, but we can also add lycra to it so that it makes it. This skirt, the bottom, this is a mermaid. So the bottom actually has the ability, we have a skirt under it, but it has the ability to be four times that big. It's oh. gorgeous when mm-hmm. it's fully blown out. Mm-hmm. Depending on the skirt, some people don't like it, but mm-hmm. the champagne with the ivory,
you're going to see a whole lot this year. I have a few coming in that are ball gown that are champagne dresses, and the applique lace around it, it's all ivory. Mm-hmm. This is another one of my versions of a new style. This actually originally was a two-piece. I did this for a bridal party that originally did not want it to be two-piece, so we closed the bag. However, then they decided they wanted a two-piece. So I was like so impressed with how this looked with just the open front that I love it. I love it. And this is probably one of my best-selling dresses this year. Mm-hmm. So it still gives you that two-piece look. You have all the glitter you'll see again. You have all the rhinestones and the shine at the top and very plain bottom. So this is going to be an ongoing trend you'll see in a lot of dresses. This is a one-of-a-kind dress. Mm-hmm. This one is the only one that's been made. This is, we were talking about wedding dresses that are two-piece. Mm-hmm. This is one that would be a two-piece wedding dress. This is a full open back. It has a high neck. No need for any jewelry aside from earrings, something in your hair. Very fitted. With this dress, I wouldn't even put a skirt underneath to poof out the mermaid. Mm. It's just so beautiful. I love to see this on a beach wedding. This is another trend, the peplum, they're back. So this whole area around your waist that you want to give it that little classic 70s or 50s look, 60s look, this was really hot back in. This is a mermaid satin dress, which you don't see a lot of people using satin dresses anymore. This one is so different because it has a lace top. The other thing that she is sporting like a champ are the gloves.
Yeah,
this year,
I noticed the gloves.
This year, you will see so many beautiful, elegant applique gloves. I have two different styles that I made, but of course we can make them out of any applique. Mm-hmm. This is a particular one that is a stretch one, and then we have the ones that actually lace on the back of your hand. The beauty of this dress, look at this. Look at that keyhole back. It's phenomenal. It brings out the elegance. It's just the whole 50s look. The hair ties into that. There's nothing bad I can say about this dress. It's a new style, it's coming back, it was old. It's white satin, which nobody likes anymore, but this makes it beautiful. Mm-hmm. Yes, we have Brittany. This is one of my favorite designs.
All of them are favorite to you.
This one I actually did last December.
Beautiful.
This is an elegant dress. It's fitted. It's a mermaid, but it's got a high neckline, but so beaded you don't need anything on the dress. Mm-hmm. It's got the illusion back with the buttons that go down the back, and elegance could not look prettier on Brittany. This is a beautiful example. I actually bustled this one up. It has a long train, but just to show a bride, this is one of the things we were speaking of earlier. When you're outside, what are you going to do with that 5-foot train? Mm-hmm. It's got to go somewhere. So the only place it can go is bustled up on the back of your dress. So this is an example of a ball gown dress that has a beautiful, this one's actually 3.5-foot train, full beading all over the dress. It's gorgeous. Corset back, so it gives you that secureness and without having to wear those undergarments that we were talking about because they're not that comfy. Oh, now we have Miss Trisha. This is one of my newest. I actually just finished this one. I got it Friday.
Beautiful.
This is a chiffon beaded top. Again, you're seeing that trend. Plain bottom, beaded top, high neck, gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous back. It's a low V back with a high neck, which is a real big trend now. This one has a gorgeous split up the side of the front left leg. This is it's not too revealing, but yet you can have that little sexy look that you want sometimes when you're in that evening dress. Mm-hmm. This is a beautiful dress for anywhere from bridesmaids to, honey, take me to dinner. Mm-hmm. I want to go out to a really nice dinner. So I love this dress. I think it's an amazing, and this one is beautiful in many colors.
Now we have
Kaula in the most beautiful.
Wow.
This will give you an example. She does not have the ball gown skirt under it, so you're not seeing the fullness of this dress, but you're seeing the train. You're seeing the glitter throughout the dress. Being in an Arabic culture, an Arabic community, this is what
they want.
Most, actually a little more, a little more bling at the top, but this. We want to see fullness. We want to see you know, I want four people to have to carry my dress
a
when I walk in.
A princess entering yes. to the hall, you
and
know?
And she looks like a princess. This is one of, I just got this in today. We just threw this in the mix. This one actually has the draped shoulders, so we can extend that and actually do chains of rhinestones going down the shoulder.
Oh, okay.
So it's a very, very, very beautiful look, and you still get that bulk.
Okay, Amanda, last advice.
Last advice, be the first one as soon as you know you're engaged to go in and look through dresses. It does not have to be here, it can be everywhere. Make sure that the dress is the one you want. Don't be forced into buying a dress. No pressure. It shouldn't be pressure. It should be beauty. And really, really be open-minded. This is the biggest thing. Be open-minded and be happy. Don't let it be stressful. We don't like
don't
stress.
Don't try because, you know, it's a stressful period.
It is.
Before the wedding.
Exactly.
I would like to thank you, Amanda. I would like to thank you, girls. You were amazing. Thank you so much.
You're welcome anytime.
And of course, for any orders or for any consultation, you're here for any bride or bride-to-be.
Yes, and we're Tuesday through Saturday, 11 to 7, so it's a big one. And I do appointments Sundays and Mondays, as long as we're not doing bridal shows or what have you.
Thank you so much, Amanda.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. بختام مقابلتنا لليوم بتمنى أنه تكونوا استمتعتوا فيها، استمتعتوا بكل هالفساتين، بكل الستايلز اللي شفتوهم، بكل الألوان، بالترند للي دارجة هالسنة هالصيفية بالأحرى، فساتين الأعراس، فساتين السهرة. مثل ما قالت أماندا آخر شيء، بتنصح كل عروس إنها تتروى باختيار فستانها، تبلش قبل بوقت لحتى تاخد وقتها وتشوف الشيء اللي هي فعلاً بتحبه واللي مقتنعة فيه، ولما تلبسه تقول هيدا هو وما بقى تغير عنه، ما تندم بعدين بعد ما تشتريه. إن شاء الله كل أيامكم بتكون أفراح، ونلتقاكم حلقة الجاية، تصبحوا على خير. آخر فقرة من فقراتنا لهالحلقة هي فقرة نيوتريشن. بفقرة نيوتريشن رح نعطيكم 5 عناصر غذائية أساسية لصحة جلدك هالصيف. تعرفوا أنه بفصل الصيف تكتر الأمراض الجلدية، ولعل أكثر خطورة هي سرطان الجلد، فإليك قائمة بالعناصر الغذائية المفيدة لتنعمي بالصحة الجلدية هالصيف. أول شيء الأسماك المدهنة. تعد أسماك السالمون، السردين والتونة مصدر هام للأوميغا 3 واللي بيأمن الحماية للجلد وبيحافظ على مرونته وبيحمي الخلايا من التأكسد ومن خطر الشيخوخة المبكرة. تناولي هالأسماك مشوية مرتين بالأسبوع. تاني شي المحار أو الأويستر، مصدر غني كتير بمعدن الزنك يلي بينعش الجلد وبيعيد إحياء الخلايا من خلال تحفيز إنتاج مادة الكولاجين. تناول المحار مرة واحدة بالأسبوع. البندورة، بتحتوي البندورة على مادة الليكوبين المضادة للأكسدة واللي بتأمن الحماية من سرطان الجلد. تناول البندورة يومياً وخصوصاً المطبوخة منها لأنها مركزة أكثر بهالمادة. السبانغ، بيجتمع بهالأوراق الخضراء مضادان للأكسدة، بيوقفوا حاجز قدام الالتهابات الجلدية. تناول السبانغ بشكل يومي عبر إدخاله لأطباق السلطة والأطباق المطبوخة. آخر عنصر وأحلى عنصر وأحبى عنصر رح تحبوه كتير وهو الشوكولات الداكنة أو دارك شوكولات. بتكتر مضادات الأكسدة بالشوكولات الداكنة يلي بتحسن عملية ضخ الدم للجلد، الأمر يلي بمده بالمواد الغذائية الأساسية لتجديد الخلايا، كما وبتحتوي على مواد بتأمن الحماية للجلد من أضرار أشعة الشمس. تناولي 10 جرامات يومياً من الشوكولات الداكنة، 10 جرامات بس مش أكتر، لتحافظي على وزنك أكيد بالصيفية. هيك منكون وصلنا لنهاية حلقتنا لليلة، بتمنى أنه تكونوا استمتعتوا فيها. منشوفكن أسبوع الجاي بنفس الموعد. تصبحوا على خير.